I wish you all a very happy new year, A Vilamba, which is year 1938 of the Hindu Shalivana era. I would also like to welcome you all to this segment of IndiaFest, where we are attempting to give you glimpses of unique rituals in a typical Telugu wedding. As the saying goes, an Indian marriage is never a mere union of a boy and a girl. It is coming together of two large extended families that back the young couple in every step of their nation married life. Not Now that the families have agreed to get their kids married, it is time to make it official and formal through an engagement ceremony. This is when the extended families get to know about the good news. Elders from Ir family gather and exchange tambulan to symbolically formalize the arrangement of marriage. This is followed by exchanging of gifts that typically include new clothes, jewelry, flowers, fruits, and traditional sweets. At the beginning of any significant event, it is customary in Hindu culture to worship Ganapati and request him to clear all obstacles. So, in preparation of the wedding, both families pick an auspicious day to offer prayers to Ganesha at their respective houses. Rice is a symbol of prosperity and signifies abundance. The women folk of the family gather for this ceremony and symbolically start to grind raw grains of paddy and turmeric roots. This ceremony officially kicks off the wedding rituals. Close to the wedding day, both sides choose an auspicious muhurtam to start the ritual of adorning the bride and the groom in traditional wedding attire at their respective homes. This ritual starts with giving them abhyangana snana, followed by dressing them in new decorative clothes and putting on the kalyana tilakam on their forehead, along with a black marking on their cheek to symbolically drive away the evil eye.
Sampradaya me sanga.
blessings for a happy and prosperous married life that she's ready to embark on. The groom, on the other hand, does a symbolic Kashi Yatra where he pretends to renounce all the worldly pleasures and take sannyas and move to Kashi. The bride's brother then stops the groom by offering him a piece of jaggery to symbolize the beautiful life ahead of him, while asking him to change his plans and marry his sister. While the groom directly arrives at the Kalyana Mandapam to be seated, the bride makes a special entrance. After all, she is Lakshmi Swarupam, that is represented by a lotus. To symbolize this, the bride sits in a bamboo basket as she is carried to the mandapam by her maternal uncles, whose house she was born at. As the bride and the groom sit across each other in the mandapam, a curtain is placed between them since it is not time yet for them to see each other. The bride's parents then perform the kanyadanam, the giving away of the bride, by using Gangajala to wash the feet of the groom, who is considered an incarnation of Lord Vishnu. The most important ritual of a Telugu wedding is Jilakara Dallam, the bride and the groom placing jaggery and cumin seed paste on each other's heads. This is the actual wedding muhurtam that has been set based on their horoscopes. It is also the moment where the new couple get to see each other for the very first time. While jaggery signifies sweeter parts of life, the cumin seeds represent the better side of it. The paste is symbolic of the inseparable nature of these emotions in life. By placing on each other's hands, the couple signify that they help each other in absorbing the essence of life. Another significant part, which is Mangalya Dharana. The groom ties the Mangalya around the bride's neck by three knots. This Mangalya consists of two circular shaped ornaments made out of gold that are joined together by a yoke shaped ornament. This signifies that the bride and the groom will team up like two bullocks on a yoke, pulling the plow, tilling the soil of life to harvest the best out of their marriage. Talambralu is one of the most joyful rituals of a Telugu wedding. In this ritual, the couple pour loads of rice on each other's heads. Since rice signifies abundance, this symbolizes the promise they make to each other to take care of one another's needs always and keep them happy at all times. The groom puts on toe rings to the bride and performs the ritual of Saptapadi, the sacred seven steps. Here the groom holds the right foot of the bride and lifts it using sacred grass and helps her take seven steps, making her seven promises as she takes each step. This is followed by a fun-filled ritual where the bride and the groom stomp on each other's toes to symbolize that during their married life, they're also capable of giving pain to each other and not just joy. The bride's sisters will then sing a Mangal Harati praying for a successful life for the new couple and ward off any evil eye cast on them. This is also the time for the bride's sisters to demand money from their new brother-in-law. Usually they will not yield or budge until their demands are met. The groom then takes the bride out of the mandapam and shows her the star of Arundhati, who is considered a great Pativrata. Astronomically true, the stars that represent Arundhati and Vasishta, which are located in the Big Dipper, are known to stay together at all times. Groom to take his new bride to his place amid a lot of celebration. The couple are given a ride in a pompously decorated palanquin. As they move towards the boy's village, all the bystanders and strangers watch the new couple in awe and bless them to lead a long, happy, and fruitful married life. Of Chinmaya Rameshwaram would like to thank Swami Ishwaranandaji for providing us the opportunity to showcase the most significant rituals of a typical Telugu wedding. I hope you all enjoyed watching our show. Hari Om.